We have now formally identified the first Illinois case of the more contagious British variant. And on top of that, there are new variants from Japan, South Africa, Nigeria, and Brazil that we also know a little bit about. But again, it's the British variant that's been identified, the first case of it, here in Illinois. We must remain vigilant if we are to maintain our progress. Honestly, that's going to be up to each and every one of us. To keep our schools open and see an economic recovery that restores jobs and businesses, we've got to wear a mask, limit interactions with people outside our households, and get vaccinated when it's our turn. Yesterday, President-elect Biden put out a serious and deliberate plan to accelerate bringing an end to this pandemic. I've had numerous conversations with the incoming administration to share the challenges the states have faced and what role the federal government must play in our recovery. So too have Republican governors. The people President-elect Biden is bringing with him into office are really an impressive group, and I look forward to partnering with the Biden administration to accelerate vaccination efforts, protect the health of Illinoisans, provide meaningful economic support to our workers and small businesses, and overall build back better. I have every reason to be optimistic for the future of Illinois and the nation, and I urge the Congress to take up the Biden plan immediately. Here on the home front in our state, today I want to lay out the infrastructure for our Illinois COVID-19 vaccination administration plan, designed to vaccinate our residents as equitably and as quickly as the manufacturers can deliver vaccines to us. Starting next week and increasing over the coming several weeks, we'll be bringing online hundreds of vaccination sites across the state, including retail pharmacy chain locations, Illinois National Guard mobile teams, state-run mass vaccination locations in northern, central, and southern Illinois, hospitals and urgent care locations, and ultimately doctor's offices and large employers who can host their own workplace clinics. By implementing a wide variety of locations, some appointment-based and some walk-up, all across the state, Illinois is driving forward with an equitable, accessible framework for administering vaccines. What's more, our plan involves building out the capacity not just to distribute the supply that we're getting right now, but to efficiently administer dramatically more doses that the new federal administration intends to deliver. The plan coordinates our 97 local health departments statewide, who operate clinics already and will open up more as vaccine supply grows. But already we've seen aggressive efforts by some. For example, the Sangamon County Health Department is unveiling a drive-through vaccination system. The Jackson County Health Department is operating vaccination clinics at the SIU Carbondale basketball arena. And yesterday, the Chicago Department of Public Health announced that it intends to have 6 mass vaccination sites up and running next week. As part of our vaccination administration plan, we are opening several new state-supported mass vaccination efforts, initially focused on the remaining phase 1A population, ensuring that the remaining unvaccinated healthcare workforce has the opportunity to begin the vaccination process. Starting this coming Tuesday, I have ordered the Illinois National Guard to activate our new flexible mobile teams to assist local health departments by expanding their existing vaccination clinics. The first 2 Guard teams are deploying to 2 Cook County health sites, and we have nearly 24 more National Guard teams ready to come online across the state in the weeks ahead as vaccination supply increases. One of those teams is already collaborating with St. Clair County Public Health Department to launch in Metro East. Others coming soon. Cook County President Tony Preckwinkle and Cook County Health CEO Israel Rocha Jr. are here with me today online to talk more about our National Guard partnership. Our retail partnerships will launch statewide the week after next, with a few Walgreens locations coming online this Monday to serve healthcare workers. And on January 25th, just 10 days from now, we will turn our attention to phase 1B across the entire state, which will predominantly serve those 65 and over. But as you know, many more on top of that. Starting Monday, January 25th, our Guard-led sites, plus Walgreens, as well as additional sites at CVS and Jewel Osco, with limited vaccine from the federal government, will begin vaccinating phase 1B residents statewide. And in the coming weeks, as supplies increase, we will announce additional pharmacy sites. But our pharmacy vaccinations will be by online appointment only. So please don't try to line up at the store or try to call your local pharmacy now. Links will be active and shared with you when the appointments are available. Patience will be required in these first weeks of phase 1B because vaccine supplies are just extremely limited. Having said that, announcements from the incoming administration have given me hope that we will see increased deliveries soon. To make this all a bit easier for the public, before January 25th, when phase 1B opens, we will launch the Illinois COVID-19 Vaccination Administration Plan website, giving everyone the ability to find a nearby vaccination site and information about how to make an appointment. All of this, however, can only extend so far when our weekly shipments remain still relatively small. We hope to see the vaccine supply grow soon, but we don't control the production process. So for a bit of context about that, when you exclude the federal long-term care program doses that are taken out of the supplies delivered to Illinois, Illinois has received a total of approximately 704,125 doses since the nationwide vaccine rollout about 4 weeks ago. That's less than 200,000 doses per week in a state of 12,700,000 people, each of whom needs to get two doses. We're all anxious to get vaccinated, but in these next few weeks, at least, patience is our watchword. So thank you. And with that, I'd like to turn it over to Dr. Ngozi Ezike.
Thank you, Governor, and good